Simon Jordan on talkSPORT.
Good morning, Mr. Jordan. How are we?
We're very well.
Good.
We're very well. Bright and sunny day.
Not half.
We're very well.
29 odd degrees today. It's looking later on in the afternoon. We've spared Trevor the trip down on the train today because we thought, nah, it's a bit much to make him travel. So he's broadcasting from home this morning. Trevor Sinclair, good morning.
Good morning, Jim. Morning, Simon.
Morning, mate.
Good
morning.
How
are we?
How's your weather up there, mate? It is, to say the least of it, extremely, extremely humid and hot down here.
Exactly the same. Look at the colour of me. I've been sunbathing in the garden. I'm feeling so glowy.
You're glowy. I like that. You're glowy. Well, glow with us this morning, Trevor. Simon Jordan is with me this morning, as he always is, right here in the news building beside the Shard on this beautiful morning. Look at that, Simon.
Beautiful.
Blue skies out there. Lovely weather in central London. Trevor Sinclair, broadcasting from home up in the northwest.
Not so beautiful.
Well,
beautiful.
Is it, Trevor? It's not bad, is it?
Absolutely beautiful. Blue sky. I mean, look at the colour of me. I've got a beautiful tan.
Yes.
I feel like I'm glowing and I can't wait to get back out.
I feel that you're looking for compliments this morning. you don't need to look for them, Trevor, because we're more than happy to throw them at you. Trevor, on a serious note, just this morning, it didn't go unnoticed here. Team GB footballers took the knee.
Yeah.
In Tokyo after rules around athletes protesting at Tokyo 2020 were relaxed by the IOC at the start of the month. Now, then you cast your mind back to last week, which saw more racist abuse aimed at Jadon Sancho, Marcus Rashford, Bukayo Saka online. It probably, I would have thought, to many, proves that footballers are absolutely right to continue taking the knee before matches going into next season. I mean, where do you stand on this, Trevor? Should these continued incidents of online abuse in any way change people's perceptions, change people's views, harden them probably more than anything else as we head into another football season?
I would say the latter, Jim. I would say they've hardened them. I mean, you have to look at what happened with Sir Lewis Hamilton as well in the F1 on Sunday. He was abused online on the, I think it was the Mercedes Twitter feeds and social media feeds, racially abused. I think it's the players, the management, football are not going to stop, because I think when they've seen the racism that the players have had to endure, and you see anti-racist activists such as Raheem, Tyrone Mings, Marcus Rashford, the work that they've done over the last years, and it continues to happen, I think the players, their teammates, their management see it firsthand. They're in the changing room. They see how it affects the players. And they have empathy for the players. They understand it now. And I think that's a huge part, the fact that they understand what their teammates are going through. And I don't think it's going to go away, because I think that empathy and the relationship that they've built, not just at domestic level, but certainly with the England national squad as well, I think it's not going to stop, and it's only going to get stronger, and they're going to stick to their guns. And it's all about equality, it's all about anti-racism, and it's all about inclusivity.